Hi guys, welcome to the Palace to the Core YouTube channel, your place for daily news, views and reviews of all things Crystal Palace. And today I'm going to be giving you my kind of two penneth worth on who I think will be starting the game against Aston Villa, and also the team news as I can find it at the moment about Aston Villa and my score prediction. So this could be good, or it could be bad, it could be a complete disaster. But before that, I just want to quickly touch on the youth team, because they played Fulham yesterday, and it was 2-0. They were 2-0 down at half time. Kofi Barmer started instead of Ollie O'Brien, and there were a couple of other changes. They played well, but they were down 2-0 at half time, which was a bit of a shame. But they pulled it all back in the second half. Two goals by John Kermani Gordon sealed it as 2-2 for Crystal Palace at the end of the game. So that was a fantastic comeback for them, and I'm sure they're really delighted by the hard work that they put into that game. So that's fantastic. So it was 2-2 between Fulham and Crystal Palace there in the youth games. And so now I'm going to get on to the main topic of the video, which is Aston Villa. And they had a good game. I mean, they beat Everton last time out. And so I'm sure that Steven Gerrard is going to be looking for more from his players coming up. He's going to be without Diego Carlos even, because he's ruptured his Achilles, so he's going to be out apparently till at least spring. So that's going to be a bad thing for Aston Villa to deal with. But apart from that, the rest of the players that they've had in have performed quite well. So including Tyrone Mings, who was at the back, who seems to have had a good game against Everton. So hopefully, for them anyway, he's going to be staying with Aston Villa. There was talk that he might be leaving, but maybe he's resurrected his career or something like that now. Who knows? But in terms of Crystal Palace, I think it's going to be slight change. I don't think we're going to be doing the five at the back that we had against Arsenal. I think it's going to be a bit more open than that. I think we're going to have the usual back four. I think we're probably going to have Anderson and Gahey in the middle, Mitchell on the left, and probably Klein on the right. I think Richards will play a part. I think he will play a part in the game at some point. Whether he will come on at half time, I don't know, but I think he will play a part, because I think he had a good game the other day. I think that we'll probably have Doucouré and Schlupp in the middle of the park, with Elise and Eze on either flank. I hope that's how it works out anyway. I hope Elise gets his first start of the season, and that Eze's good form continues, because he had a great game against Arsenal and he's had a great pre-season. So I think he's looking confident, he's looking back to form. So I think that's going to be, that's what it's going to be in the middle of the park. And up front, I think it's going to be Zaha, obviously, and I think Edouard, because I think he hasn't played that badly and he's been created a few chances. So I think Edouard may well get the nod ahead of Mateta on that situation. In terms of Ebiowe, I don't know. I hope he plays in the game. I hope he gets some time in the game, because in the few minutes that we saw the other day in the other game, I thought he was really good. He was quite energetic on the ball and trying to do little tricks here and there, and he was really working very hard. So I think that I hope we see Ebiowe at some point. That'd be great to see him. But let me know what you think. Let me know who you think is going to be on the pitch, whether you agree with me, or whether you think it's going to be slightly different. Score-wise, I am thinking it's probably going to be two. It's going to be close. I think it's going to be 2-1 to Crystal Palace. I think we've got enough that we're going to be able to turn over Aston Villa. I know it's always a tight game between us and Aston Villa, but I think we're going to have just enough. And I'm predicting it's going to be 2-1 to Crystal Palace. But let me know what you think down below in the comments, whether you think it's going to be 2-1 or whether it's going to be something completely different. Let me know down in the comments, as always.